Welcome aboard. Welcome aboard, Concrete Contractors. This is Danny Barrera with Concrete Marketing Crew. We're excited to have you for another episode of Your Concrete Success Podcast, where we discuss success strategies for owners, marketers, and operators of concrete companies. Look, here's the bottom line. If you are the owner or a marketer of a concrete company, you'll know that one of the most important things is to consistently bring in new projects to your business, to consistently schedule projects out and be booked solid throughout the season and start booking out for the next season. So in this video, I thought it would be a good idea to talk about what a complete marketing plan entails, what it has. And I'm not talking just about any kind of, pie in the sky type of marketing plan for concrete contractors. I'm talking about what exactly is it that we do for concrete contractors. And if you don't know who we are Concrete Marketing Crew. We specialize in helping flat work and decorative concrete contractors win online. And our promise is to double your concrete leads without having to split your profits with lead vendors or referrals. So I don't know if you've ever been in that position where you have general contractors sending you business, where you have referrals sending you business at a cost, at a percentage of the project, while they don't do any work. And while that's great, I'm not saying that's bad, but I can tell you, if you want to maximize your opportunities and you really want to blow up online, this is the way to do it. So I will be introducing you to, let me make the screen a little bit bigger here. Let me see if I can make this a little bit bigger, actually. There we go. Let me make this a little bit bigger for you. The Concrete Contractors Online Dominance Program, which is the marketing plan that we've built out and we've proven and tested and continue to refine for concrete contractors. Now, we work with concrete contractors throughout the United States, and one of the things that what they think is that we do is just one little piece of the puzzle. Well, what we've built out is a comprehensive plan that doesn't just tackle one area of your online marketing, but rather takes care of the entire thing. Because here's what you're gonna find out. You're gonna need to take care of your website so that it generates leads. You're gonna need to get traffic to that website so that it generates leads. You're going to need to send paid traffic campaigns that are targeted for those individuals and the type of projects you want if you want leads really quick. You're gonna need to take care of your online reputation if you wanna get more leads and win more projects. You're gonna need to post consistently on social media if you want to stay relevant. You're gonna need to manage your leads and improve conversions if you want to streamline and grow and scale your operations. And you're going to need to know your numbers. So that's exactly what we're going to talk about here. And this is what we've called the Concrete Contractors Online Dominance Program. It's really turned to be the Concrete Marketing Plan. This is the internet marketing plan for concrete contractors for maximum flow of calls, leads, profitability, for your flat work and decorative concrete business. So it all starts out with step number one, which is your website. Now, a concrete contractor website is not just any type of website. It's not just a Wix website or a Weebly website or just having a homepage and about us and a main generalized services pages or a gallery page. What a concrete website, which is what we called HAS, is that it actually has a page for each and every one of the services that you have and you offer, as well as one page per each one of the service areas that you service. And what that's going to do is cast a net, almost like Home Advisor does, like Yelp does, like Triple B that does. And each one of those pages is optimized, is mobile friendly, and it's ready to start generating leads for your business. So when we launch any of these type of websites, we've noticed that at the very minimum, at the lowest, our contractors are able to double their leads. And this is why our value proposition is double your leads with our concrete marketing plan, because the website is built to generate those type of results. So again, your website is the home base, and over time, your website also serves as a selling tool, because if you do any type of decorative type of projects, for example, you're going to need your color guide. You're going to need to give your prospects some sort of idea into what type of work you do. You're going to need to show them samples of your projects. And the best way to do that is by you leveraging your website as a selling tool and you learning how to direct and drive your prospective clients through your website, through the service pages, through the different buttons, through the different sections. And that is all built out in your concrete website. So again, the main point for us is to generate more business for your business. So we built out concrete contractor websites that are designed to get leads, beautiful photo galleries, fast and mobile responsive, and are 100% unique content. And this is not content that we pull out of thin air. This is content that's optimized, as well as content that is relevant. It's relevant to what you service, what you offer. So the beautiful part about having this type of service offering for concrete contractors is that the concrete contractors come to us. They just tell us the services they offer, the service area, and we take care of the rest. Right, then we basically send them a sample of the website when it's ready to go live. We work through a couple of modifications and then we go live. It's very minimal amount of input that's required for this type of website. So your concrete marketing plan should and must include a website that's built to generate leads, that it's built to rank on the search engines, that is built to showcase your work, that is fast and mobile responsive, and it's got 100% unique content that Google ranks. Okay, let's move into step number two here, and that is to get on the maps. We've talked about Google My Business listings. That is a big part, a huge part of a marketing plan for concrete contractors in today's day and age, is to get on the Google Maps, and not just anywhere, but really to get into the top three positions for the most relevant searches that are coming out, and every single search that is relevant for your business. Now, does that happen overnight? Absolutely not. But there is a way and there is a plan. So a couple of things we try to accomplish is local SEO, is having a plan that takes care of your local search engine optimization, meaning it helps you get found in your geographical service area. Number two, it helps you become the best known and most reputable concrete contractor in your service area. So by you optimizing your Google My Business listing and utilizing all these different best practices that I've shared with you in these other videos in the past and podcasts, you are going to be able to take away some of those strategies and tips and then start to become better known in your service area. Once you start sharing your reviews, your work online and social media, you will notice a difference as you will start getting more phone calls. And the goal here is not just to get ranked on the top three for certain keywords. The goal is to really capture a real segment of your geographical service area where you are based out of and blow up on the Google Maps section. So that is step number two of a concrete marketing plan. Step number three is search engine optimization dominance, SEO dominance. So what does that entail? Well, you probably know Home Advisor. You probably know Angie's List. You probably know Yelp. You probably know triplebee.org. You probably know yellowpages.com. You probably know all those lead generation websites that keep calling you, trying to sell you leads. Well, I want to have you consider like the one thing that they've got figured out that you might not have figured out if they're generating leads in your service area is that they actually have an SEO search engine optimization plan in place where they are ranking. So the first goal is to rank and bank on Google search. That means for every service you offer in every service area, you want to have some form of presence. If you're not getting found, your competitors are getting found. If you're not getting found, your competitors are the ones that are going to get found and get the leads and get the projects in those service areas. So SEO dominance is about establishing for all your services in your service area, and this takes time. SEO is not an overnight type of exercise, or do it once and set it and forget it. SEO is a continuous optimization and addition of pages. So how do we recommend doing this? Well, we recommend doing it by phases. We have a 90-day roadmap that really basically sets up the foundation for growth. And after those 90 days, we revisit the plan and optimize for another 90 days. And the reason being is that there will be algorithm changes throughout the year. And we want to make sure that we are staying on top of what needs to be stayed on top of, that we analyze all the different pages that we have ranking. We can see what's working, what's not working, and optimize from there. Most contractors that have quote unquote tried to do SEO probably have done it by hiring someone from Fiverr or from Craigslist, and they've never gotten any real results. So having a strategy is very important. So having a fully optimized website, we talked about having a concrete website. Well, your website should have a very good foundation for SEO structure. So if you bring a Wix or a Weebly website and try to do an entire SEO dominance type of plan with that website, is most likely not going to work just because of the architecture. There's a lot of technical nuances that we don't get to talk about here, but that go into building a website that Google loves to crawl, Google loves to rank, that gets found, that is fast and responsive. So those things are to be put into consideration here. Now, the other thing is ranking for all your services in all your service areas. That means that the amount of pages needed, those will probably need to be split out. So just to give you some sort of idea, the smallest websites that we launch are about 20 pages. When we launch, 20 pages, no less than 20 pages. And after that, probably within 3 months window, we're probably close to 40 or 50 pages worth of content, worth of all the services in all the different service areas. And it continues to grow time, month and month and month again. That's why those websites become so powerful and so relevant in the service area, because they have the right strategy. And that is part of the SEO dominance plan. Now, your SEO plan, your search engine optimization plan, should include consistent and fresh new content, just like I talked about. And then something that I'm not going to go in depth here is the link building, because there is a lot of noise in the industry about how to do link building for local websites, for contractor websites. We actually have a webinar coming up, okay, at the end of May, and this webinar is going to go in depth into building an SEO strategy for concrete contractors, how to rank and bank so that you can generate more concrete leads. So if you're interested on that, click on the link right in the description, or go to concretemarketingcrew.com/webinar, and you should get a link right there. Let's go to step number four, and this is concrete leads on demand. So as you're starting out your website, that takes time, right? As you're starting out the Google My Business optimization, that takes time, okay? As you're starting out the rollout of your search engine optimization, that takes time, okay? You will need leads now. You will need to put food on the table right now. So there are a couple of ways that you can generate leads. Two of the most prominent ways right now is, number one is Google Ads. Google is very powerful because it's inbound traffic, and Facebook is powerful as well, but it takes a little bit more of a sales process. You need to have a very robust sales process to convert those leads, just because you are pushing. You're not pulling the traffic to you. You're pushing your message into a wide area, and it's a small percentage of individuals that raise their hands, but a lot of times they are just on Facebook to be on Facebook. They're not on Facebook to look at concrete flooring or to look at stamped concrete. They're not on Facebook to look at epoxy coatings or garage floors. People are on Facebook to look at what their friends are doing, right? To catch up with people. So think about that. Leads that come from Facebook, you need more leads just for the fact that the people that are on Facebook are there to hang out, right? Just to chill. And the individuals that are on Google are there intentionally searching for your services. So again, you are paying more for the leads on Facebook, on Google, excuse me. You are going to be paying more, but the quality of conversion is going to be much higher and much better. This morning, we were talking to one of our clients, Mike, and he was saying, hey, look, I'm getting better quality leads. I'm getting less leads, but better quality projects, bigger projects from leads from Google. And that is coming straight from Google, not from the social media stuff. So very important, concrete leads on demand. We do recommend, depending on your service area, if you're in the Texas area, very competitive. Florida is very competitive. Ohio is very competitive. But depending on your specific service area, you will need a minimum viable budget, which is calculated during the assessment of the cost per click. So you need to look and research the cost per click on Google search. You can use a tool like the Google Keyword Planner, where you can search all the different keywords that you're going to be targeting and have a good idea of how much the cost per clicks are. And then usually what we recommend on the low end, by default, a low converting page is going to be 5%. So you're going to need to do the calculation right there. So you can do times what? 5% conversion, you're going to need to multiply that. You're going to need to divide your numbers and then see how much that's going to come out to. And then on Facebook, it's going to be a matter of looking at the audience size. Instead of looking at the cost per click to calculate, you're going to rather look at the audience size, and that you're going to be able to gauge from there. If the larger the audience, the more leads that you're going to get, and the cheaper the cost per lead. The smaller the audience, smaller the pocket, is going to be the opposite. All right, with that being said, once you start generating leads on demand, which is as literal as 24 to 72 hours, step number 5 is to continue growing your 5-star reviews online. And this is not just Google. This includes Facebook. This includes Yelp and any major profile that you have for your business. Like, this is something that should be proactively getting done, for the sake that this also becomes a selling tool for your business and on your behalf. So you do not need to be talking about how great your company is or how great your concrete services are if you have a stellar reputation on Google. And the bottom line is that at the end of the day, not 100% of your clients are going to be fully satisfied. Some of the best concrete contractors and concrete companies, some of our best clients, which deliver some of the best and most finest work in the industry, get 1-star reviews as well. So there is no exception there. There's really no exception there. Like, I've seen this time and time again. And sometimes it's a matter of misunderstanding. Sometimes it's a matter of miscommunication. But look, here's the thing, is you can't please everyone. You can't make them all happy for as much as you try. Now, your job is to make sure that you weed out and you deal with any problems and situations before your clients go to Google, go to Yelp, and leave a bad review. So that should be your goal, to be proactive. So the part of the grow your 5-star reviews and reputation management should be about filtering out those negative sentiment reviews or negative sentiment clients, and then funnel them in through some sort of customer handling, customer service path, where you can help and deal with that situation before it goes online, right? And otherwise, you can have a path for them, if they are satisfied with your work, to leave you a positive review. The next step is social media management. And this one comes as number 6. A lot of people start there, okay, and it's great. But this one is just one of those things that you've got to be consistent. You've got to be consistent in showing up every day, showing off your brand, showing off your work, and consistently attracting and compelling people to contact you for a free estimate or free quote. And unless you are putting money into advertising, like, for example, Facebook ads, you cannot expect big returns from social media right out of the gate. This is a long-term play. This is something that it's given that you got to have, that prospective clients expect you to have and maintained. So it's very important that you consistently, you know, start out posting at least a couple of times a week, at the very minimum 2 times per week, and you post projects or faces of your projects, and you showcase your employees, you showcase your work. If you have reviews that you'd like to showcase, that is something that you should be putting out there. And in fact, one of our social media managers here is creating really beautiful graphics for our clients, where it's showcasing basically all the reviews from these different channels, right? House, Google, from Facebook, and picking out all these different quotable reviews that someone can read with the picture of your work in the background. So if you want to check some of those out, feel free to contact us at concretemarketingcrew.com. Again, that is included as part of the concrete marketing plan. Now, step number 7 is the lead conversion and lead management. If you are just getting emails of the leads and not able to see and manage the leads and track the sources, you are pretty much going blindly at this. You're not going to be able to determine which channel is sending you the most leads and jobs. Because here's the thing, is you're going to have word of mouth referral, and you will not know if the leads that came to you came directly from someone giving a neighbor your phone number, or if someone went to your Google My Business and clicked there, or if someone went to your website and clicked there from an organic search, or if someone went to your landing page and clicked there and submitted their information there. So if you don't have any type of tracking or reporting in place, that is something that we've worked extremely hard, and we continue to do this all the time, to work very hard to get our grip into data, into transparency, so that the reporting is crystal clear. So the lead conversion and management is about having a centralized CRM per se that allows you to manage the leads and the conversations that you're having with prospective clients. This is the same CRM that we use to request reviews for our clients. So it's integrated. It's one solution that allows to do those things. And step number 8 is zero hype, 100% transparency, and it's your business, your marketing, and you get to do it right out of the gate. So getting concrete results is about working from a place of facts. You want to work from a place of a factual, real information that is not hype based. So many times do we get compelled to listen to a salesperson just tell us about how many searches are happening in the service area, how many people are looking for our services, and then you buy into whatever they're selling you, and you look at the results, and they do not correlate with what you thought it was, right? So working from a place of truth and facts is very important. So we have a policy here at Concrete Marketing Crew where it's zero hype. We have to be upfront. There's a lot of people that call us and they want us to do business with them, but their expectations are just not aligned with the service area. And that is something that you should be well aware of. So that happens all in the market research. So again, if you haven't done that market research yet, this is why we encourage concrete contractors to reach out to us at concretemarketingcrew.com to request a free concrete marketing strategy call. And that is where we go in depth. We analyze your service area. We look at trending services in what service areas you offer. And then we correlate all that information so that we can present that to you. So that's zero hype. It is what the market is doing on a month-to-month basis. 100% transparency. It's your business, your marketing. Your business, your marketing. This, your marketing plan should be yours. You see, now if you have an agency that partners with you and then delivers the work, well, it's your business. It's your website. It's your social media. So we have another policy here where we do not hold clients hostage. We do not hold you hostage to anything. It's your website. If you decide to ever stop working with us, then basically it's your website. Now, we do encourage you to look at this as a real plan of action and not quit, not give yourself a couple of months and then say, hey, this doesn't work. No, you got to give it 30 days, 90 days, 180 days to really see the power of what this whole concrete marketing plan is all about. The other thing is doing it right the first time. So if you don't do your website right from the beginning, I can tell you one thing, you're going to have to do it again. Plain and simple, it's like concrete. Your website is the foundation. It's the foundation that Google My Business is gonna, you know, is gonna depend on. It's a foundation that it's gonna be a sales tool, a selling point for your business. It's a foundation that works on your behalf 24/7. So if you don't do it right the first time, you will have to do it again. So we by default redo our clients' website from the beginning. And no, it doesn't cost you an arm and a leg. So make sure that you reach out to us to find out more information. So second thing is your Google My Business listing. It should be yours under your ownership, as well as all your social media accounts and every single account, every advertising account, anything that is your businesses should be under your 100% ownership, not your employees, not someone else's, under your ownership. And consolidate all that information. So that is one thing that I can see, I can tell you we've mastered here at Concrete Marketing Crew, is at bringing all those pieces together for our clients so that they understand, hey, everything is under one place and we're managing everything under one roof instead of having it flying around all over the place. So that is pretty much it. That is what the Concrete Contractors Online Dominance Program and the Concrete, a complete intermarketing plan for concrete contractors look like. It's basically having all their ducks in a row. This does not include offline mediums. This does not include lunch and learns or networking. This is online, right? This has to do with your internet marketing plan. And if you want a copy of this graphic, feel free to reach out to us at concretemarketingcrew.com. And in fact, go ahead and download a copy of our internet marketing plan for concrete contractors. Just head on over to concretemarketingcrew.com today. Download your free copy. And until the next episode, thank you so much for tuning in. We appreciate your time. Have a great rest of your day. Make it a good one.